I want to share with you guys a very unique way where I utilize technology in this field of spine surgery to expand the indications and the ability for us to preserve motion for our patients. One of the main reasons why we can't do disc replacement surgery in patients is because the bone density, unfortunately, does decrease as we get older. So how do you strengthen the bone? Obviously, we want to be proactive. We want to build our bone by doing weight-bearing exercises, making sure that our vitamin D is checked, making sure that we do bone density scans. But we can't escape the reality of life that there's some bone resorption that happens no matter what. And so in order to elevate and be able to offer disc replacement surgery, one of the unique things that I do is by building that bone using an older technology called kyphoplasty, which is using bone cement, but using robotic technology to be able to do a very targeted strengthening of the bone where we need it most. And I'm going to show you how I'm using the Mazor robot to actually achieve this. So what you're seeing here is the planning software for the robotic technology, and here are the levels that we had to put the anchors because the patient needed a fusion at these top two levels, right? And so you can see I've already done the inner body cage device in order to restore the disc heights between L3-4 and L4-5, right? And what I have done at L5-S1, because the patient had good joints in the back, there was no significant arthritis in these lower levels. I had done a disc replacement surgery. This is the prodisc L device. You can see at the upper level, the person had really bad arthritis, which is why we couldn't do a replacement here. So, you know, we did what's called a hybrid construct. And then what you're seeing here is instead of using a trajectory for screw at S1 and L5, I did an additional trajectory with the robotic planning to actually fill this space right where the disc replacement sits so that we can buttress his bone and preserve the motion at that bottom level, right? The bottom level is one of the most critical levels because if you don't have good lumbosacral motion, all that stress is going to be transferred to the other joints, the SI joints, the hip joints. And so this is a really unique way of beefing up the bone, doing it in a very accurate way with the robotic technology, and achieving the best result that I can for my patient.